A section of members of parliament under the Greater North Parliamentary Group have started on consultations to amend the Police Act Cap 303 to restrict appointment of Inspector General of Police to persons that have served in police positions for at least 4 years.
A senior position of not less than 4 years in the police force, because we feel then this person can understand the administration and management of police better and will help the police run better.
Addressing the press conference at Parliament today, the woman MP for Rua District, Paparo Lilian, noted that the move is to ensure experienced police leadership.
They should be treated like any other Ugandan, like any other force like UPDF, so that people work hard and aspire. Now, if you fear promotion because you think you're still, you know, it will contravene what you want to offer to this country.
MPs want police officers who are appointed to top ranks of IGPs not to be forced to retire at expiry of their contracts, like what has happened to the likes of IGP Asan Kasinje Edward Ochom, among others.
It is unfair in the sense that it is making a number of competent police officers to kind of mark time. They don't want to get promoted to a point where eventually they can be, they have to retire.
We know people retire at the age of 60. In UPDF, they retire at the age of 60, but the generals even go up to the age of 65. Then why should the police be forced to retire at the age of 55 or even less?
MPs want an overhaul of Police Act with several proposed amendments. They want to describe qualifications of a person to be appointed Inspector General of Police and Deputy and provide for their duties and specified term of office.
In the police, minimum from a commissioner upwards for not less than 4 years. And we are saying there should be terms and conditions for how long is this person going to serve in the office. For right now it is open. We are saying this person appointed should serve for 4 years and eligible for reappointment.
The Greater North also wants to make provisions for deployment of police officers outside Uganda. MPs want police deployments abroad to be cleared by Parliament, just like it applies to UPDF.
This amendment also aims at making provision for the deployment of police officers outside this country. When you look at the current situation, we have so many forces, particularly the Uganda police, in other countries, Mogadishu and other places.
We need the deployment of the police outside the country to be clear. For sure, I want to inform the country that we have fellow Ugandans who go and look for jobs outside the country, more especially in Saudi Arabia, United Arab Emirates, and so on.
Lawmakers claim the current legal regime in police doesn't guarantee justice to police officers.
If a police officer committed a crime in Arua, and another officer commits the same crime, maybe in Kasese, you will find when the processes go on, the penalties given to these people are different.
You may fail to know who is the police officer, who is a UPDF, who is a security person. You may not even understand, including even the uniform that they put on.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.